Hey guys, welcome back to another new video. If you're new here, I'm Yan Ai, a first year medical student at University Science Malaysia. I know a lot of you might have received your interview letter. Congratulations! I'm really, really happy for all of you. For now, before entering medical school, just relax, chill, and spend time with your families and friends as much as you could. I will break down this video into 4 parts, so just feel free to skip to the part that you need. I went for USM, UKM, UTA and IMU interview, and grateful enough, I passed all of my interviews. So hopefully my experience could help you to perform well in your interview as well and get into the medical school you want. Without further ado, let's start. First, how to get into medical school. You can do matriculation, STPM, A-levels, ASAC, and a lot more. A little background of me, I did A-level and I used my A-level result to get into medical school through UPU. Yes, they do accept A-level students through UPU and also STPM students, just that our chances of getting in is slightly thinner compared to those who did matriculations or ASAC. Let's move on to the main part of this video. How to prepare before your interview. I think the most important thing you have to prepare before your interview is to make sure you do survey for the school you are interviewing for. Doing survey for the university is extremely important because the more you show the interviewers how much you are interested in their university, the higher chances they will accept you. And for those who are applying for USM, I will briefly talk about the USM academic structure at the end of this video, so stay to the end. Even though different medical schools will ask about different topics, but there are a few common topics that will be repeating over and over again, such as abortion, organ donation, euthanasia, contract doctor, anti-vaccine, patient's confidentiality. Yeah, so make sure you read through all these articles and also prepare yourself with some basic knowledge. I will attach down below the file for patients' right so that you guys can go and read more about it. It's extremely important to read from a reliable source because they might ask during your interview like where you get this information from. The first one is Medic Portal. I know a lot of my friends use it to prepare for their interview. It's more like an interview question bank. They will have a lot of common questions about interview so that you can have a brief idea of what they're going to ask during the interview session. And the second one is Med School Insider. But I honestly didn't use these two resources, so I couldn't comment much about it. The resources that I use to prepare for my interviews are YouTube and also Google. I just search on Google like what are the common topics or what are the common questions that are going to come out during medical interviews. And there are actually quite a lot of questions that you can access online that are provided with answers as well. And another important thing is, please read about the 4 pillars of medicine. This is really, really, really important because basically all of the answers during your interview will be surrounded with these 4 pillars of medicine. So for USM medical interview, you were given 15 minutes and you will have 5 stations, 5 people in a group, and you will be assigned to the different breakout rooms. There will be one general station that will ask you about why you choose to do medicine, why you choose USM. Did you put USM as your first choice? If no, why not? And what is your strength? What is your weakness? And also like, what do you know about USM? Actually, for this station, the questions that they ask really rely on how you answer the interviewer. So just bear in mind that don't go too deep and don't be too lengthy. Just keep your answer short, precise, and straight to the point. For me, I remember because I talk about cancer and epilepsy, so they ask me like, do you know what department is in charge of epilepsy, what department is in charge of cancer? And the 4 other stations left are scenario-based questions, which they will give you a question for you to read about 1 or 2 minutes. One of the stations you are compulsory to speak in Malay. And the three other stations really depends on you whether you want to speak in Malay or English. For this scenario-based question, there is no right or no wrong for the answer as well. And most of the question will not require any professional knowledge. For example, they might ask you like, one of your friends is trying to commit suicide. What will you do? Will you enclose this secret to other people or will you keep it to yourself? Alright, so next is, do not beat around the bush if you already have the answer in your mind. And during your interview sessions, be more natural. And I think, yeah, that's pretty much it about the important things that you have to take note during the interview session. Oh yeah, make sure your background is clean so that you will look more professional. Move on to the academic structure of USM. We will have an end of semester exam at the end of each semester. Unlike UKM, UKM have their exam every month, but we only have two per year. We will have a buddy system, like seniors from year two will guide juniors from year one. If you have any doubts or you have any problems with your academics or with your life, you can just reach out to your buddies and they are actually very willing to help. And for those who are applying for USM Medicine and who really want to impress your interviewers during your interview, a very, very, very important tip that I'm going to share with you, which is mercy. Mercy is actually a concept that is created by USM professor. It is used during our PBL session. So PBL stands for Problem-Based Learning Session. So the main objective of creating this mercy is to help us to become doctors that are more holistic. M stands for medical issue, E stands for empathy, R stands for respect and right, I stands for insights. So take my previous PBR as an example. We have our trigger and we'll break it down into mercy. M is the medical issue. So what is the medical issue that our patient is facing? Empathy. How do you show empathy to your patient? And communication. How do you communicate with your patient? R is like, what is your patient rights? This is the special part of our USM academic structure, which I think you guys can really mention during your interview. It will really help you to stand out. I know a lot of people might be fear having the thought that USM is at Kelantan and maybe Kelantan is a more conservative place. But actually, when you came here, you will realize that there's actually quite a lot of entertainment. For example, in our school, we will have a lot of activities, or we have a lot of jamuan. If you are a sports lover, trust me, you will love USM because we have a lot of sport days, sport activities throughout the year. And even though you are a person who do not play sports like me, they are also very willing to teach us. Like recently, I'm trying to learn volleyball and all of my classmates, they are super friendly, they are super cute. They're like, ajak us like, hey, we want to go volleyball today. There are a lot of fun activities and events going on at USM throughout the year. So if you're interested in to find out more about the activities that we organize, feel free to follow this page, Team Murni Nurani, or this Bihepa, and also our MedSoc page and our AMSA USM KK page, and also Ophelia page, which is my batch, year one. We will constantly upload activities or events that are going on at USM. And if you want to know more about a daily life of a medical student at USM, feel free to follow my Instagram. I will update my daily life on my Instagram regularly. Well, I believe I have clearly stated what you should take note before your interview and during your interview. So I wish you all the best in your medical interviews. Hopefully, see you guys at USM. Bye.